गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई डॉक्टर ब्रिजेश शंकर राव देशमुख वेलकम यू ऑल अंडर द रूफ ऑफ कमला एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज प्रतिभा जूनियर कॉलेज. इट्स माय इमेंस प्रिविलेज टू कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स दोज हैव सक्सेसफुली टेकन एडमिशन इन प्रतिभा जूनियर कॉलेज. मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर ब्रिजेश इज अ लैंग्वेज टीचर. We are going to learn English subject, the criteria introduced by HSC board. We are having the variations of the students like from state board, CBSE, ICSE, other boards. Even we are having the students from the vernacular medium in junior college. But don't worry, the new syllabus which has been designed last year is going to help to each and every student to understand the basic concepts of language. It is helpful to everyone to groom themselves from all the way to achieve the bright success in future. As it is truly said, English is the mirror of life. Absolutely, it is the mirror. It is the door of life. Nationally, at international level, everywhere, English is going to help one to craft and to make their image. So, in our syllabus, all such a qualities has been inculcated by HSC board with the help of authors. And the syllabus, which we will discuss further on, is quite remarkable and quite helpful, as I have said earlier, to groom one and all. So let's check it out. What exactly the changes has been introduced by the board of HSC in their 11th standard. First of all, you can check this out. This is the beginning page of your textbook. This is a textbook which you have to purchase from the market. You can go for the hard copy. Even I'll share the soft copy of this textbook on your respective class groups. Check this out. Here we can see the images of remarkable personalities as Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, William Shakespeare, then at the mid, Emily Dickinson, then Charlotte Bronte, and the most immense is, you can check this out, a lady, a simple farm woman is working in the farm. Actually, she is doing the farming of paddy. Paddy means farming of rice. That lady is doing the farming of rice. And into the corner side, you can get to see a server which is linked by computer or the teams. That is what our 21st century. Our 21st century is well known for its techno-savvy or technological world or technological things. So all those things has been inculcated in the very syllabus. One by one, I would like to talk about Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar. His lesson is going to help us to understand what is the preamble, what are the rights of the people, a common man, how crafted his image, what he had done for the society. We should always remain grateful for his deeds. And that's what the lesson is going to highlight. The time we are going to start the studies of actual lessons or actual textbook. That is what Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, the well-renowned personality. Then I'll go for William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare, the pioneer of English drama and literature, who has introduced to the world what is the drama and how drama can be performed on the stage. Also, his well-renowned drama novels, poetry, there's always mesmerizes to the world. So this syllabus, we are having a masterpiece of William Shakespeare also. Emily Dickinson, Charlie Bronte or Bronte sisters, and Martha. Also, the simple nature of India, or the actual India, resides in the villages, according to the quote of Dr. or according to the quote of Swami Vivekananda. So that's what also covered in the very lesson, or that's what also covered in the textbook, along with technology, how technology is making everything easy for the mankind, for the humankind. That's what, like, every single aspect has been introduced into the textbook. And simply, if I have to quote about the text, then I would like to quote that literature is the mirror of life. What is the meaning of this concept? Literature is the mirror of life. It means whatever we are observing around us. Many of the time we come across to a number of the things, like good things, bad things, oddities, tough times, number of the things. So literature tries to show all those things through the word that can be in the form of prose passages, or that can be in the form of poetry or drama, novel, and so on. If we are going to divide poetry passages and the long work, for example, poetry, it's a small piece of work which helps us to understand the implied meaning. Poetry makes us to think beyond to the meaning of words. The critical appreciation of poetry always helps one to broaden the horizons of their thinking. Passages in the form of short or long stories, they help us to understand our life in a better way. And novels, dramas, particularly dramas, they are performed on the stage. We can come across to the thing that any XYZ character may be similar to us, may be similar to our friends, families, or the lifelike incident. That's what the drama. And the novels are having different forms. Novels are having different forms as fictional novel, epistolary novel, or imaginary, fantasy, suspense, that is known as a gothic novel in our English. We are having gothic word instead of using suspense novel. So there are a number of the forms of literature. Directly or indirectly, they help us to understand our life in a better way. So all those qualities, all those characteristics has been inculcated in the textbook, which has been designed and approved by AJC Board for Standard 11. In the course of time, we are going to discuss everything in detail, okay? Now, let's check this out ahead. This is the content that you have to study for your exam for 11th standard. 1.1, you can see that I have made a star over there. The title 1.1 is not visible. I have done it purposefully because that lesson has been reduced or cut down by the HSC board for this year. 1.1, the lesson will not be there for the studies this year. Then 1.2, onto the summit, we reach the top. 1.3, the call of the soil. 1.4, pillars of democracy, which is written by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. 1.5, necessities. 1.6, Tiger Hills, from the poetry. 2.1, cherry tree. 2.2, the sower. 2.3, there is another sky. 2.4, upon Westminster Bridge. 2.5, nose versus eyes. This prose and poetry will be there for the studies. आप लोगों को इस साल 1.1 जो लेसन था वो इस साल के लिए एग्जाम में नहीं रहेगा. एंड 2.6 तो 0.5 के बाद भी आपको एक स्टार दिखेगा. दैट पोएट्री ऑल्सो हैज बीन रिड्यूस्ड और डिडक्टेड बाय द बोर्ड फॉर दिस ईयर सिलेबस. सो यू हैव टू स्टडी 1.2 टू 1.6 प्रोज एंड 2.1 टू 2.5 पोएट्री सेक्शन. ओके, ऑल द प्रोज एंड पोएट्रीज आर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. ऑन टू द समिट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ हाउ द माउंटेन्स कैन बी स्केल्ड एंड व्हाट आर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ रिलेशन द कॉल ऑफ द सॉइल दैट वी शुड रिस्पेक्ट व्हाट वी हैव indirectly. That is the central theme of the lesson that I have left it here in front of you. Pillars of democracy. Democracy, what is democracy? That we the people, or for the people, we need to stand together, we need to stand steady, we need to stand fast, so we can make our nation stronger, better and livable place to one and all. That's what the characteristic, or that's what the remarkable thing Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar has inculcated in our nation. That's what we are going to discuss in the pillars of democracy. To make our democracy to be stronger, to make our nation to be stronger, we need to stand together. We should hold the unity. We should stand together. All those things, unity and diversity, that is what our India is well known. All those characteristics have been covered under the lesson pillars of democracy. As I said, it is a lifelike lesson that whatever we are going to do in life, that is going to come back to us. That's what has been introduced into the very lesson. Tiger Hills is again an experience, or it is again the lesson which is going to make us proud. It will enlighten us to do something for the nation. That's what has been covered under the lesson Tiger Hills, which is introduced by General Ved Prakash Malik. Then from the poetry session, we have to discuss Territory, which is written by Ruskin Bond, a well-known by birth British, but by identity an Indian writer. He made us to understand the values of nature, the values of our surroundings. The sower, Victor Hugo, has explained us what you are going to do, what you are going to sow, so you are going to write. Aap jo karoge, wahi paoge. That's what the poem Sower has explained. There is another guy, M.L. Dickinson, has truly helped one and all never to be get disappointed in the life. Every problem has solution. So be positive, look forward and go ahead. Next poem, Upon Westminster Bridge. Under this poem, William Wordsworth explains this, how the city is always running 24/7. It is just like moving on and on and on. But somewhere, sometime we need peace, we need harmony, we need peace to find ourselves. That's what William Wordsworth explains under the poem Upon Westminster Bridge. Then 2.5, Nose versus Eyes, is a quite hypocritic poem which has been introduced by the writer William Cowper. This poem is going to help us to understand how the life goes on. Many of the time we come across to the nostalgic approaches, which we goes on like complaining, we always give excuses, those never work, and we always broaches the things those never been that important in our life. So what is important, what is not important, until unless we bifurcate all those things, we cannot go ahead in life. That's what William Cowper has explained under the title 2.5, Nose versus Eye poem. Quite fine. This is the general introduction of your prose and poetry. Now, you have to keep one thing in your mind. The way CBSE, ICSE, state board student used to receive passage And on the basis of that passage, they used to get the questions. Little bit. Likewise structure has been followed here also in junior college for 11th and 12th standard English paper. Likewise structure is there. So you will have passages, and on the basis of those passages you will get questions. There will be one seen passage, there will be one unseen passage, and from the prose, sorry, from the poetry section you will get two questions on poetry. One poem will be there for 8 marks in detail. Like you will get the poem, and on the basis of that poem you are supposed to attend the asked questions. That will be for 8 marks, and for 5 marks there will be a critical appreciation of poetry. Now what is critical appreciation? That we will discuss further on in today's session. I would like to just introduce you in critical appreciation. You have to keep 5 things in your mind. That is, comment about the writer, comment about the title, what is the central message or central idea has been introduced in the poem, then what is the style or the language or the figure of speech has been inculcated in the very poem, and what message the poem delivers. These 5 points you have to keep in your mind, and you have to elaborate them in an appropriate way. For example, if you have got the lesson or if you have got the poem Cherry Tree, which is written by Ruskin Bond. So first of all, you have to do the introduction of writer Ruskin Bond within a 3 to 4 lines. Then you will comment about the title, whether the title is remarkable, apt or not. You have to explain the importance of title Cherry Tree. Then what is the central idea of the poem that you have to explain in detail? Minimum 6 to 7 lines has to be narrated or need to be penned down. After that you have to explain the style of the poem. What is the language of the poem? Is it lucid, difficult? What figure of speech is, like simile, alliteration, metaphor, personification, antithesis? Which figure of speech has been covered in the poem? That you have to give minimum 2 to 3 examples. And by the end you have to conclude in your own language by writing the conclusion. What you have understood from the poem, how the poem is remarkable for one and all to look forward into their life. That is what the critical appreciation of the poem, the question of critical appreciation will be there for 5 marks. Let me come back to the prose section. You will have passage for 12 plus 4 marks. You will get the scene passage for 12 plus 4 marks. Under 12 marks, you are going to get 2 on 2 marks questions, like 12 marks total passage will be there. And under that passage, you are going to have 2 on 2 marks questions based on the passage. And for 4 marks, there will be a grammar from the scene section. And in unseen passage, you are going to get 12 plus 4 marks dividation. 12 marks questions will be there on the basis of unseen passage, where textual, contextual, personal response questions along with the vocabulary, grammar will be there for 12 marks. And for rest of the 4 marks, there will be a summary writing, note making, information transfer, and all those things will be there under the section of unseen passage. Now I hope the introductory section of prose and poetry and about your listening is going to help you to understand the structure of your English textbook or the syllabus. So I, Dr. Brijesh Shankara Deshmukh, is now taking your leave from today's session. I'll see you in next session to discuss about the views about the textbook and about the language. Thank you. Take care. Have a good day.